So today I'm going to show you guys how to coarse spin alpaca. And what we actually have here is some huacaya alpaca. And you see the staple length on this is, you know, probably about 3 inches or so. Not super long. It is really soft and lofty and just beautiful fiber. And I'm super excited to spin it. I do have it put into roving here, and this is actually what I sell on the site. So the roving is so much nicer to work with and make it into yarn. So I am using the roving. Again, this is 100% huacaya alpaca. Spinning Surrey alpaca is a totally different thing. So we're just going to talk about huacaya today. So because it is a smaller staple length, when I get started here, I generally don't go too far from the orifice when I'm doing my drafting. And I tend to pull from down lower and then allow it to suck up from there. I don't want to separate too far, else I'm going to pull those fibers apart on the roving since we have that pretty short staple length. If this had been blended with wool, it's much more flexible in terms of how you want to spin it. And you can go back really far and help make a more narrow yarn. Because this is the 100% huacaya, it's a little bit, you have to pay attention a little bit more to how far you're allowing that roving to pull apart as you're drafting it onto the bobbin. So in terms of the bobbin, this is kind of what we have going on. This is what it looks like. Don't mind my lead rope there. You can see it has that typical halo appearance of alpaca, which is very common for alpaca. It's very soft and yet very sturdy. And I plan to actually ply this with some white Surrey huacaya mix and put it together into a two-ply yarn. So thanks for checking that out. Hopefully that helped show you a little bit more about the black roving that we have for the huacaya alpaca and what it looks like spinning it.